Hello everybody, so today is Sunday and I am making puri and aloo ki sabzi. But the aloo ki sabzi is more like a Bihari style. So I thought why not to share the recipe with you. It will be a little different. Being a Bengali, it is little different than the potato curry. So first I have boiled the potatoes and after that I have taken the black cumin seeds, which is kalonji. I've added a little bit of this onion, little bit of chilies, and then I've chopped some tomatoes. So I am gonna fry them all, and then I've also boiled the potatoes. I will just mash the potato and add some oil, some water to it. So it is a little different kind of aloo chokha, which is in Bihari style but not in Bengali style. So I have added little chopped tomatoes, and the aloo is already boiled. So make sure that the boiled aloo is completely boiled, because it has to be mashed. So this is completely boiled, and after everything gets a little, completely cooked, not completely, yeah, but partially cooked, then I'm gonna add the mashed potatoes and add a little bit of water, warm yolk water. And then add a normal little salt and little of sweetness, sugar or jaggery to complete this curry. So I've added a little bit of red chili powder, little turmeric, little sugar. And if you wanted to add chaat masala or amchur, you can definitely go ahead and do that. So I have added the mashed potatoes. The boiled potatoes, I have mashed it. You can just place it and then kind of press that up. Now I'm gonna add a little bit of water and let this shimmer, and then just put whatever is you can add lukewarm water, because that will something retain the taste of the aloo curry. But I'm adding a normal water, increasing the flame, and you can mash it. You can add more potatoes as well, but I am not adding that much. Now you have to add a little bit of water later, but this is what initial consistency is. So let that completely get a little bit of shimmer, and add all the spices should get into the mashed potato, and then I'm gonna add a little more water. Now this is a complete Bihari style aloo chokha. So this is what the consistency is. This is the final consistency. I am not gonna add more of water or something like that. Then I have some coriander to garnish with, and I'm just gonna garnish this with a pinch full of coriander. So if you don't like it, you can definitely skip it. But I actually love coriander, so that's pretty much. So this is what the gravy actually looks like, and I really love the way the taste have turned. So do check salt and sugar before you turn off the gas. This is the aloo chokha of Bihari style and can be served with puri. So I hope this video was a little helpful. If yes, then do take a moment to follow me on Instagram and Facebook, and all the handles will be in the description box. Have a happy Sunday. Thank you so much for watching. Do take a moment to follow me on Instagram and Facebook. Do make sure that you have subscribed to my channel and also hit the like button for more such updates. And that's pretty much. I will see you very soon with yet another video.